All right, so here we are to the last slide. Well, not the last slide, but this will be the last video for this series of the Wholesome and Human and the God Working Among Mortals. And so this one, if I have to put it in my personal opinion, that would be a tedious title to do because it requires you to max 30 titles in the games, and some of the titles in the game requires a significant amount of farming to get in order for you to get it max. And it should have something like this, and because some of them tied in with a title from the Horn of Monument, so I'm just gonna borrow the list from the Horn of Monument to show you what sort of title that you should be looking for. Now this one obviously is from the Nightfall campaign, and you have to talk to somebody NPC before you go and kill the mob in a certain maps. And you know, when you get the buff from the NPC and then you use that buff and then you go and kill the mobs, it will reward you with the Lightbringer points, and that will contribute you to the Lightbringer title. Now the eternal Lightbringer, this one is to display to the Horns of a Human, but in the for God Working Among Mortals, this one will have a different name, and it will be called Holy Lightbringer, if I remember that correctly. Holy Lightbringer. So yes, it's not I just borrowed the list from the Horn of a Human. It won't have the same name with the Horn of a Human, but it has the same functionality meter the meter track. You need to reach the maximum levels before you can actually add it into your title track. And so once you achieve 5 title, it will reward you with kind of a big deal. And then once you reach 10 titles max, you have People Know Me. I'm very important for the 50, 20 is that I have many little about books. And yeah, and then the final one is the God Working Amongst Mortals. Oh, so that's what it's called. I thought it was pronounced among. Okay, Amongst Mortals. Okay, I'm gonna have to fix this. Well, actually, I'm kind of lazy, so we're just gonna have to use this one. All right, so God Working Amongst Mortals is the final title that you will receive, that this title track will reward you with. And you know, some of them can be extremely time consuming. Let me just give you an example. Okay, for the Nightfall campaign, it will take you approximately around 7 to 10 hours for you to reach the maximum level. Now if you do the Nightfall campaign with the book, now the experience book is the book that you can exchange that for the Lightbringer points, and some of them can be exchanged for other points, but I usually use that for the Lightbringer because the Lightbringer is the hardest one in the Nightfall campaign. Between the Lightbringer and the Sunspear, there are two of them that you can receive, that you can get in the Nightfall campaign. One of them is the Lightbringer, and the second one is called the Sunspear. These two are the easiest that you can get, but compare between the two of them, the Lightbringer is a little bit harder because you won't receive it until you reach about 70% of the campaign. About 70% completion of the campaign, then you will have the access to get the Lightbringer. Compared to the Sunspear, you have the Rider Star. So for the book, I usually exchange the points from the book to the Lightbringer instead of the Sunspear, because by the time that you reach 100% of the campaign, you know your Sunspear title would be around level 8, and you need to have it in level 10 to be able to max it out. But maxing the Sunspear is not really that hard, honestly. You need to do the Vanquish anyway, and when you Vanquish, you contribute to the Sunspear. And for the Booker, it will be the same, but it's in the Eye of the North. These three will be in Eye of the North. Ebon Vanguard is the same. Now for the Tyrion Cartographer, I already explained it in my previous video for the 30 out of the 50 points that you can use the tool for you to explore and clear out the fog in the map. But that would be very time consuming because Tyria map is from the Prophecy, and from the Prophecy is the biggest map. So it will take quite a while for you to complete. On average, it will take me about 1 hour to finish Vanquish. And I usually combine the Vanquish with the exploration just to save me the time. And so using this estimation, there are, let me see, 1, 2, 3, about 20 maps, 20 to, yeah, about 20 maps or so. You have to forgive me for this because there are so many maps that I can't remember on top of my head right now. But that would take you 20 maps, 20 hours to complete the Vanquish. But please keep that in mind that some of the map are a little bit longer, so you may have to spend about an hour and a half or 2 hours plus for one map. 2 hours plus for one map. Yeah, it doesn't look like 2 hours plus, but let me just clear it off. 2 hours plus for one map. And yeah, it's very, very time consuming. So be prepared to spend a lot of time into doing the Vanquish as well as doing the cartographer. Because sometimes, some of the cartographer on the first attempt, you just couldn't get it right. And then you go back and then you redo it, then you get it right for some reason. I don't know. Because that's happened to me a couple of times. So for the Eternal Legendary title, as I already said in my previous videos, that when you complete the Eternal Guardian of Tyria, Eternal Guardian of Faction, and Eternal Guardian of Nightfall, the game will reward you with the Legendary Guardian upon completion of those three. So you get one extra. Now for the Skill Hunter, I already explained it in my video for 30 out of 50, so I'm not going to mention it again. Now for the Vanquisher, when you successfully vanquish all of the map in a expansion, you will receive the Eternal Eternal Kantha Vanquisher that you can display into the Horn of Monument, and also it can be counted toward to one of the title, and that because you already max it, so it can be counted toward that one too. Now for the Eternal Savior of the Kujix or the Luxons, for the Horn of Monument, you don't have to max to display. For the Horns of Monument only. But if you choose to do it for the kind of a big deal title track, you need 10 million points. And that will take a very long time for you to do, because you know you have to farm a lot of you need to keep repeatedly doing the Vanquish as well as doing the dungeons, Ugots for the Kujix or the Deep for the Luxons, and you need to farm the speed clear region you need to do the speed clear to farm for the points at either, I can't remember the name of this region right now. I'll link down the description below so you can have a look at it. For the Kujik and or for the Luxion, which is this one. And again, you have to forgive me for forgetting the name because I'm not really good at remember the names for these two regions, Kujik and the Luxons. Alright, and yes, I just mentioned it in my previous video, so I'm not gonna mention these again. For the speed clear method, and for Elonian cartographer, it's the same with Eteria and it's the same with Kantha. There will be a tool for you to use, but if you it's up to you to choose to use it or not. It's entirely up to you. And for the Elhound and for the party animal, these are the consumable. And as I said earlier in my video for 30 out of 50 30 or 50 for the points for the Horns of a Human that you need to do the you need to farm the events. If you, you know, you need to farm the events if you want to have them. Either you spend the money to buy them from the other players or you farm it yourself. And there will be a video in that. There will be a video called for tier farming, just for me to explain to you what are, you know, what sort of method that I use for farming some of the consumables. And it will be included in this video as well. You know, you can have a look at my previous video in 30 or 50 points, or you can have a look at this the description box inside this video for the consumer for the consumable method farming for these two. And I'm not gonna mention it again because I already mentioned it in my previous video. So legendary cartographer, which is when you complete the three Kantha cartographer, Tyria cartographer, and also the Alona, that will give you one. Right, legendary guardian, I already explained that. Legendary skill hunter, the same thing with legendary cartographer. You need to complete three. One, two, and three. You need to complete three of them. It will give you, same thing with this. Sweet tooth consumable, I already mentioned it. Not gonna mention it again. Spear marshal, which is sun spear. Sun spear title. And it's linked with Lightbringer. Survival, there'll be a list in here for you to have a look at the method that I use to maximize my survival title track. It's easy, just AFK, but there's other method as well, and I will include a link down in the description, but I don't think you would like them, honestly, because you know, the AFK method is what I use. I just, you know, left my computer going on, you know, like you know, perform the task and left it going when I'm, you know, off to go to work. External hero of Tyria, external hero of Kantha, and external hero of Alona. This is the completion of your campaign. This display into the Horns of a Human. So yeah, that's pretty much it for the God working amongst mortals. And I did explain to you in my previous video on how to do the Vanquish and all the things, so I'm not gonna mention again. But you know, when I say, when I showed you this, it's look like, oh, it looks simple, you just maximize the title. No, it's not that simple. It's required time commitment, and yes, as I mentioned earlier in the 30 to 50 points, I already cover most of the method for you to be able to maximize your to be able to do all of this and to maximize your title in that. So yeah, it sounds simple in this video, but if you have a look back in my 30 or 50 video, it would not be simple, trust me on this. And at the moment, I'm sitting at 22. And I started back in December, first week of December of 2014. And until now, which is the 2nd of July 2015, that's approximately 8 months. And I only get 22. And for my Horns of a Human, I think I get like 32. 50 or so, can't remember. Yeah, so it requires a lot of time and commitment, and that's 8 months already, and I haven't even close to maximum, you know, close to like what 90% of that yet. So be prepared to spend about a year for you to get this title. Worth it? Hell no. I mean, no, not really. If you just want the skin, hell no. I mean, like if you really really like the game and it, and you really like the title, then yeah, sure. But for some other people, they just want to have the skin, and you know, the effort they're spending into getting this one is, I know, in my personal opinion, you don't need it. Yeah, you just don't need it. That's, it's very subjective in terms of, you know, taste and preferences. So, you know, some people might prefer to, you know, to maximize every title tracks and get the God working amongst mortals. Compared to me, I mean, I just you know, I'm happy with 32 or 50. But since I already reached 22, so I might as well go for 30 points. For the, I mean, a 30 title track, just so that I can get a god working amongst my mortal. But other than that, I would not try to get 50 or 50 because it's very, very time consuming. And I already spent 8 months of playing this. And yeah, I'm at the point of I can't be fuck doing it anymore. So yeah, like I said earlier in my video of introduction, I did show you in my previous video in the 30 or 50 points on how to get to 50 points, and also in this video explaining how to get the god working amongst mortals. But yeah, I don't think I will be getting 50 or 50 points. I don't think I'll be getting 50 or 50 points. But if you're aiming for that, good luck. And you know, I have to congratulate you once you successfully complete 50 or 50 and then getting a god working amongst Momoto, because yes, you deserve it, because honestly, it's very time consuming and a lot of people spend a lot of time into getting this. And you know, a lot of time, a lot of commitment, and a lot of money spent. You know, not real money, but in-game money. So, yep. All right, so that's it for the god working amongst Momoto. Now, okay, so here we are for the speed clear video. Now, this won't be a very detailed video. The reason for that is because if I want to show you every single role and every single how to do each individual elite content, each individual dungeon, it would be, you know, way out of the scope of, you know, just giving you the information on what the speed clear is, and also, you know, how some of the steps that you need to be aware of before you go in and do it. And sometimes the dungeon, it will be better for me to just talk about a particular dungeon in a single video compared to, you know, comparing to putting all of them into the speed clear. And also, if I put them, every single one of them, into this video, that will push the time limit to over 10 hours. And I don't think that would be a good idea for me to do it, because, you know, you'll be overwhelmed with a lot of information. And some of you just, you know, you just want to have a look at a particular dungeon or elite zone to know, to see what is it like. And another thing that I need to mention is that I haven't done all of the speed clear for all of the elite contents in the game. I have done the official war in the speed clear, and I have done the underworld for the casual speed clear, and I also done it in the speed clear. But the amount of speed clear that I have done for the underworld is only 2, and the amount of for the official words is about 3 or 4. I can't remember. Official war, I did quite a bit of the both casual speed clear and also the proper speed clear, or, you know, another term that you want to call it is like perfect speed clear. And for the Domain of Anguish, I honestly haven't done any speed clear for that. The reason for the Domain of Anguish is, for some reason, I just couldn't find a group for me to do it, and also my guild seems they seem not to be bothered doing it that much, honestly. And I only done, you know, casual, normal playthrough with some of my friends, and also I did a lot of them by myself, because I just want to know what is that elite content is about, and I will cover it in a little bit more detail after the introductions. So let me just go over the term first. Now, in my definition for my my definition for this from my understanding of the speed clear is that it is a process of completing the dungeon or an elite content or contents as fast as you can. Now, from my observation, there are 2 types of speed clear, as I mentioned to you earlier in my previous slides, that a perfect speed clear, or sometimes people referring it to be as a doing it professionally. I know it sounds a little bit cheesy, but I don't know why some veteran players I talk to, they prefer to call it you know, we do it professionally. I mean, like, I have nothing against it, but it sounds a little bit cheesy for me. I usually prefer to use the term perfect speed clear or proper speed clear. Either one of those two is fine, but doing it professionally, it sounds a little bit cheesy, but I can live with that, not a big deal. And the second one, which is what I usually do with my guild and with my alliance and also some of the personal friends that I do it for my personal team. And the good thing about having a personal team is that you know what that person is capable of, and you know what is his or her weaknesses and what is his or her strengths. So you can make up for, you know, for their weaknesses, and you can rely on their strength to cover up your weaknesses. And so it's, you know, forming an understanding is the key. And I would highly encourage you to find someone that you can trust to form a personal team. But obviously the game has been going on for like 10 years already, so finding a personal team is kind of difficult. I wouldn't say it's impossible, but it's kind of difficult when you're just first starting out. You need to join a guild or the alliance, and you need to look for somebody, run with them for a couple of times, maybe 10 times or 20 times, before you decide to, you know, form a personal team, or they decide to take you in for their personal team. So again, it's a time commitment process, and it wouldn't be done in a day or two. You know, it would take time for you to do it, so just please be aware of that. And yeah, like I say, for the casual speed clear, it's still a speed clear, but doing it in a more relaxed way. Yes, I understand that you guys want to do it as fast as you can, but the thing is that imagine that you have done it for like 20 or 30 times or even 40 times for a particular elite content. By the time that you reach, let's take the Fissure War, for example, when you do it for the proper or perfect speed clear, you finish it off in 30 minutes, right? But if you're starting to do it for like, if you have completed like 30 times, that's a lot. 30 minutes for, you know, 30 times, that's a lot of hours into doing that. And, you know, you do the same task over and over and over again, depending on your role. You know, there's a tank, there's a damage dealer, and there's a healer. And then you keep on, you know, you perform on that role for 30 times. And by that time, you'll probably be like, oh, I just couldn't be fucked doing it anymore. And because of that, you know, you feel kind of like relax your way a little bit, instead of, you know, at the beginning, you feel so pumped, hype, and you just want to finish as fast as you can, because, you know, you feel like it's a challenge. But then after doing it for so many times, you just don't feel like it's a challenge for you anymore. And you do it, you know, in a more relaxed way. So in the perfect speed clear, like I said, Fissure War usually it took me about 30 minutes to finish. And for the casual speed clear, it's about 40 to 50 minutes, or a little bit more, depending on who are you running with, obviously. Now, there are three most common elite zones that people do. The first one is the Fissure War, which is what I just mentioned. And the second one is the Underworld. And the third one is the Domain of Anguish. And like I said earlier, I haven't done any speed clear for the Domain of Anguish, because I just couldn't find any. And my guild doesn't seem to be running the Domain of Anguish. I mean, like, I have some members in my guild and some member in the Alliance, but we just couldn't find a proper tank and Terra. Usually it's a tank. Or the secondary tank for us to do the Domain of Anguish. And so for the Domain of Anguish, I will include a link down in the description for all of these elite zones, but I will include them in, for the Fissure War, I only include the normal one, because I don't do proper speed clear for the Fissure War anymore. And besides, I don't do several roles. So for the Fissure War, right, just to give you an idea what it's like, you need to have a tank. 2 tera, tera 1, tera 2, and there is a Voss. Voss is a devish class, and Voss usually the main damage dealer that we take in, and we usually prefer to have at least 3 Voss. And we have the Unyielding Aura. Unyielding Aura is the build for the monk. This one is a monk. This one is a devish. And this one is an assassin. And also another assassin. Now, the assassin, for those of you who just start up into the game or haven't been doing any speed clear, the reason why we prefer to have the assassin as a main profession is because the assassin has the access to the skill, and also for the attribute we call it shadow art and shadow form. And the shadow form allows you to be immune to damage. I mean, not damage, but the spell that casts onto the assassin. So mobs won't be able to cast any spell onto you. And so it ensuring that you survive a little bit longer. And so combining with a proper build, you can pretty much tank everything in the official world. And so this will be the first one, will be the main tank. So what exactly is the main tank? Well, the main tank will, in the official world, you will be divided into three groups. Let me just clear that. Three groups, right? The first group will be one of the main tank. We call it MT, plus 3 Voss, which is a damage dealer, devish damage dealer, plus the Unyielding Aura monk. And then we have 1 Terra, which is T1, and we have T2. Now, in the official world, there are three main areas that we divide the task to. The main tank, because in the official world, there will be 11 quests, if I remember that correctly, 10 or 11 quests. And because of so many quests, for you to do, it will be more efficient and effective if, you know, we divide it into three groups and each group take one, you know, take a particular amount of quests and then finish it off. So for the Terra one, this is a solo assassin. This is from my understanding, solo assassin, and another solo assassin. You do it by yourself. You don't go with a group or anything like that. You do it by yourself. And I haven't done any of these roles, so I cannot comment on it. But I will link you to the build and also to the Wikipedia where they show you each individual role that you can have a look at it. And you know, I mean, sure, I would like to learn the particular role, but because of my time schedule is a little bit tight, and when I try to gather up with other people, they already, you know, the majority of the people I run with, they already determine which role they would do beforehand. And so I always ended up with using my Vosh damage dealer devish. And after explaining this, I will show you a short video that what does it mean for me to, yeah, what does it mean to use the voice device? Yeah, what I mean by using the voice device. So I'll show you the video later on, but for now, where was I? Yeah, Terra 1 and Terra 2. Now for the Terra 1, for my understanding, and for the Terra 2 is that you go in a separate way. Usually the Terra 2 is going down at the south and cover up a little bit of the east side. And for Terra 1, you go up into the north and then you cover it up at the top of the map. And I will include my explanations for the speed clear in my video of the official world. Now this official world, like I said earlier, the video that I have done is in the normal mode, but I will explain to you why we divide it into three parts, and you know the task of each individual group. So this is group one. This is the main group. This is group one, and this is the main group. This is group two. Oh no, I'm sorry. This is group. Yeah, this is group two, and this is group three. I wouldn't say it's a group because it's more like one person, but yeah, you get what I mean. So for the group one, the reason why we are using three voice devs is because a particular in that particular elite zone, there are some of the mobs that require you to kill them, as fast as you can. But it would be easier for your group to do it instead of having the two solo sim to go inside of that particular, you know, a particular doing the particular regions or the quest, because you take the quest. The quest will direct you into a particular map, you know, at the corner of the map, and then you start killing some of the mobs and stuff like that. So for Tier 1 and Tier 2, they divide, you know, the people in the past that they recommend Tier 1 to go at the top, and Tier 2 is going at the bottom. And for the main tank and the main group, they usually go to the central. The center of the map, and also they go to the west. And so when you divide it into three groups like this, it would make it easier for you to complete within the time frame of 30 minutes. But 30 minutes is a perfect speed clear, so every single one of us every single one person in the team, he or she has to know what exactly is his role or her role and how to execute the skill perfectly. And so to demonstrate for you what exactly the voice devil's damage dealer role, I will just stop the video for a second, and I'll come back after I show you the short video that I have done using my voice devil's. So just be back in a second. Alright, so this is the official Wolf short video that I want to show you. What does it mean to be a voice damage dealer devish? And I think that this video I completed back in February or March or so. So it's, you know, it's an old video. And as you can see in here that we have two assassins, the Terra one, and I think it's a Terra one, and the other one, which is a main tank. Now, because I have done this, because I recorded this video few months ago, so I can't exactly remember what did we decide to go in at that time. But it seems to me that we couldn't find a Terra 2 or something, and so we decided just to make up with a ritual, not a ritualist. This is ritualist. I was going to say ranger. Yeah, we using a ritualist to go in with us, and I just couldn't figure out what did we decide back then. I just can't remember. So the idea, ideally we would want to have three devices for the damage, and also we want to have one of the monk for the unyielding aura spells, which is one of the elite, which I will include out in the description. What does it mean? What does unyielding aura means? And also the main tank and the Terra 1 or Terra 2 or something like that. I can't remember on top of my head right now, but either one of those two. So this is the according to this video, I've done this in the hard mode, and when he say pop, that means the consumable, and the consumable, that's one of them, that's the second one, and that is the third one. We usually pop the three of them up because these three would not only increase your armor, increase your health points, but it's also increase your attributes, and it's also increase your chance of reducing the time recharge for your spell, so you can cast it faster, and it also increase your the movement speed or something like that, and it's also increase your recharge of spells. Yeah, recharge of spell, so the cooldown is faster. So say if you have the cooldown of the spell like 5 seconds, with the consumable when it pops up, it will cooldown say 3 seconds or something like that. Yeah, so we always pop 3 of them up, and I will include a link down in the description where you can get them, and just don't be cheap. When you starting to do the speed clear, just please don't be cheap, alright? You rather spend a decent amount of money to buy the consumable, or you can farm for the material for the consumable and just pop them up. I mean, like, if the return for you to do the elite content versus the return versus the cost that you spend for the consumable, it's like nothing. I mean, yeah, I rather pop the consumable, finish off the entire elite content zone, and then getting the material that I need, rather than failing it and then waste another consumable and waste everybody's time, because time is, you cannot get it back, right? So this is just a the group consumable, but they also have the personal consumable. Personal consumable is the consumable that you can only cast it on yourself and not for the team. For the team one, there's only 3 of them that they can buff, but there's also another one, which is the morale. I'm not sure during this video if we pop any morale consumable, but for the personal consumable, if you pop your personal consumable, you will be, for the devish, you will be extremely strong. You can finish off the entire pack of mobs by yourself, and I will show you what it means. So let me just fast forward a little bit. I think somewhere along here that I remember that he, one of my guild leaders, this guy is my previous guild leader, no, not previous, but several guilds before making of this this video. Yes, 4 months ago, he was my guild leader, so about 4 months ago. Yeah, you have to forgive me for the time, because like, I record this one so long ago, so, and I completely, I just can't remember what did we decide for this video, and also what guild was he in, what guild was I in. So as you can see that the main tank gather the mobs and pull all of them into a pack, and look at him, just him, not me, this is me, alright, just look at him, see this, all of them are dead, and they drop blood, and they drop a lot of stuff, see, boom, again, just look at him, all by himself. He used both the consumable and the group consumable as well, so just look at him again. Yeah, you see this? I didn't even jump in. He did it all by himself. So that's how powerful a devish can be when you have the consumable fully geared and with the appropriate consumable and appropriate build. That's how you can kill them. That's how powerful it is, and see how many of the mobs that he can kill all by himself. Now, this is when I'm jumping, I think. I starting to remember this video now. Again, Shadow Form is the spell that will prevent the mobs or any other mobs to cast spell on you. And the main tank has to have this elite spell with him. Otherwise, you know, it wouldn't work in this elite content. So he gathered all of the mobs, right? He gathered all of the mobs into a pack, and he stacked them behind, I think behind the corner of this gate right here. And then my guild leader pops up with a vow of strength, and also pop up with the shard or something like that. I can't remember the name of this 7 button spell right now. But I did sort of remember the combination. Because last time that I used my voice devish was like 2 months ago. I started doing the underworld in hard mode, and when I started to do the underworld, I stopped doing the fish of war. So I kind of forget the combination, but I remember that I have to pop the valve strength, and I remember I had to pop the shot, and then I pop this one up for the survival. And once he pop up the Ebon Battle Standard of Honor, that's when he telling us that, okay, go in. And so when he popped that, I popped this one. And then I jumped in. I jumped in using the shadow. I can't remember the name of this skill right now, but it has something to do with shadow. And so when I pop in the shadow, I will teleport myself into the pack of the mobs, and then I just execute 1, 2, and 3. Yeah, look at that. Look at how much damage that I have done. Just one. And then I pop another one, and on 1, 2, and 3, these are the ones that will stack on top of each other. So when you execute one of them, and when you tap in the second one, it will execute it immediately. So see, and that's like what, let me just rewind a little bit. So at the time that I jumped in, so that's 49. So that's 49. Okay, 49. So about 6 seconds. 7 seconds. Yeah, 7 seconds for us to kill all of them. See how fast it is? And, you know, that's the job of the Devish Voss. And for the job of the Terra 1 and Terra 2 and the main tank, I will include the link down in the description. So to show you from the perspective of, from the view of those roles, because I haven't done them. I haven't done any of the main tanks role or the Terra 1 or Terra 2. So I cannot speak for them. I only, my role, my main role is usually I became a damage dealer for the Fish of War, for the Voss Devish. And for the Underworld, sometimes I be a damage dealer, but I also be a semi-support and damage dealer as well. By semi-support and damage dealer, I mean I become a SOS, which is a Signet of Spirit. But I also use my Signet, I use my spirits to block the mobs coming to my team. And I will explain that in more detail for my video about that one. But again, I will include the link down in the description for this zone, but I done it in the normal mode, so you know exactly the route for Terra 1, Terra 2 and the main tank, and also for the main group. Alright, so I'm gonna stop here, and I'm just gonna back to the slide. Just before I go back to the slide, just one more time, just gonna show you this one more time of how powerful the Devish can be if it's properly geared and also properly used the consumable. Just look at him. He has the personal consumable and he has the group consumable as well. Look at that. Jumped in, boom. I didn't even jump in, and let's see. It was 36. At 136, he jumped in. No, actually 135. Okay, 135, he jumped in, and about 7 seconds. About 7 seconds. This one is a little bit, you know, left over, but it's just one. But the point is, he finished the entire mobs of this, except for, you know, one left over. This entire pack, he killed them all by himself. So that's how powerful the Voss Devish can be. So that's why I'm suggesting in my earlier video for 30R50 that you, or you know, in the slide of the God Working title, you should be preparing to have a Voss Devish if you want to run this kind of content. And by all means, some other zones that require the Voss Devish too. Some of the dungeons require Voss Devish too. So yeah, if you can't make one, then make one, because you know you're gonna be benefit in the long run. So alright, so that's it for this short video about the Voss Devish damage dealer role. I will come back to the slide, so see you then. Alright, so that was for the Voss Devish short video. And now I think that I'm pretty much covered everything that I wanted to say for the visual world in its own. But for the underworld, right? I also have a video that I do. Excuse me, that I also do the casual speed clear. I haven't done proper speed clear for this one because you know most of the group that I run through, I haven't done that many proper speed clear for this one. I think I've done like two or three, but I can't remember exactly. But I did a lot of casual speed clear for this one, and also I did a couple of normal ones just for me to get a feel. But when I did a normal one, I did with other friends, so I wouldn't exactly to call that a normal run. Because the guy that I ran with, he sort of know already what to do. So when we did it, it's sort of like in between of the casual speed clear and the normal run. So I don't know, I don't have the term for that. So yeah, again, I didn't do a lot of proper speed clear for the underworld, but I did the casual speed clear for this one. And so my video will be based on the casual speed clear instead, because I have done so many underworld for the casual speed clear, and I see no point for me to do it with heroes again, to show you exactly how it can be done with the heroes. So yeah, I mean, I just don't have the motivation to do it again with the heroes, since I already done so many of them, so many of the underworld with my group, with my personal group. But I will show you my role, which is a damage dealer for the casual speed clear in the underworld, and I will explain to you what are the zones that you need to be aware of when you go into that map, that underworld map. Alright, so, and again, the link is down in the description, have a look at it. And for the domain of anguish, like I said, I haven't done any speed clear for this one, like none. For the underworld, I did a few proper speed clear and a lot of casual speed clear, and the same with the official war. But for the domain of anguish, no, I haven't done any. At the time of filming this, I haven't done a single proper speed clear for the domain of anguish, because I just couldn't find anybody to do it with. I mean, like my guild, there are some members that express their interest of doing the domain of anguish, but we just couldn't find a proper tank and a proper group to do it. So you know, so for the video of the domain of anguish, this is the most difficult zone in my personal opinion, in the rank of difficulty. In my personal opinion, domain of anguish is the most difficult. The second one is the underworld, and the easiest of the easy is official war. So the domain of anguish, like I said, I haven't done any proper speed clear. So when I include a link for you to have a look at the domain of anguish, it will be in the normal mode that I show you. The way I did it with myself and seven heroes, clear out the entire domain of anguish. And please be aware that I did it in the normal mode. I did not do it on the hard mode because it just took me so much time for me to find an appropriate build that works with my team. And a lot of people told me that, oh, you should have a look at the video online and stuff like that to improve your build. But when I have a look at a few of the videos, they seem to, you know, their hero structure seems to be, you know, not what I want my team to be. And also, when I try some of the build that they have online, it just doesn't seem appeal to me for some reason. And I try that, and it just doesn't fit me. If I have to put it away, it doesn't fit me. So when I show you my video that I did for the domain of anguish, it tailored to me, okay? And feel free to, you know, copy that build and, you know, run it with your team. If that build is, you know, you're comfortable with it, you find it useful, yeah, feel free to use it. But I mean, like, if you don't find it appealing, if you don't find it comfortable with you, feel free to check out other people, and I will link down in the description. Some of the articles that I found online at the Guild Wars Guru and Guild Wars Wikipedia and etc. So that it will help you in doing that domain of anguish, which is yourself and the seven heroes. But if you do have any friends that help you do the domain of anguish, by all means, I mean, you know, they are going to help you, right? So you might as well use their helps. But when I did the domain of anguish, when I was in my one of the guilds in the past that just doesn't, they just didn't want to do it. I mean, yeah, it's just that simple. They didn't want to do it. And because of that, I had to improvise and I have to do it by myself. But I did take into consideration of some other builds that I have found online, but some of them, it just doesn't appeal to me. So some of the builds that I took a few of them, and then improved it in a sense that it fit with my playstyle. So when you have a look at it, just be aware that it's not me invented all of the builds. It's just me borrowing some of the builds that people in the past that, you know, find working, and then I improvise it and then tailor it to fit with my playstyle. Because some of them, I think they're using like a warrior, the main warrior for fashion, but I mean, I'm using a ritualist, main for fashion. And, you know, other people may be using a necromancer as a main for fashion. So the playstyle is very diverse. And because of that, you know, if your main for fashion is different than mine, then it might not work in your favor. And so you have to just copy some of the build, some of the attribute in my build that you think is gonna help you, and then improvise it to fit with your main character and your playstyle. So yeah, all right. So that's pretty much it. And as for the dungeon, for the speed clear of the dungeon, it varies. Now, I did show a video for this one, for the Ugo's one. It was one of them I did in a normal mode that I successfully reached the final boss, but then I failed that one. The reason why I failed that one is so that I can show you some of the mistakes that the majority of the people that I have met, you know, the mistake that they make when they reach the final boss is that they don't microcode properly. And I also explained in that video, you know, some of the tips and the tricks in that one. So please feel free to check that one out. It'll be in the description as well. For the deep, I haven't finalized my video for the deep yet. At the time of filming this, I haven't finalized the video for the deep yet. So I will have to work on that and finalize it as soon as I can. Hopefully I can get it done by middle of July or a little bit later. I don't think I can. If I cannot post it by the end of July, then I have to postpone it in around middle of August or something like that. But we'll see. But I don't think it'll be later than, you know, August anyway. And for this dungeon, I complete this. But I haven't finalized the video for this one. And for the shards of ore, I complete this one as well. But I haven't uploaded yet. I don't think I uploaded yet. So I'll have to upload it later on. But at the time of filming this, I haven't uploaded the shards of ore. I haven't uploaded this one. Yeah, I don't think so. So I'll upload this. And as for the dungeons, like I said, it varies for, you know, what kind of dungeon is your guilds or your allies, you know, comfortable with running with. And, you know, in my allies, right, they run Ugots. Jesus fucking Christ, like 7 times a day or maybe more, I don't know. Like they run 7 times a day. And I know that some of the allies run the deep for the Luxons. For, you know, 10 times a day or something like that. And I have seen a lot of people in my allies running this dungeon, this one, and also this one. And so it depends on the taste, really. But for the elite zones, these three are the most common one. I haven't seen other ones. There are a few more, and The one that I came to my mind is the Tomb of Primeval King. Primeval King. Yeah, I can't write for shit for this one, but yeah. Tomb of Primeval King, and I think that there's another one as well. It's called the was it a dungeon or was it a content? Another one that came to my mind is the Sorrows Furnace. Sorrows Furnace. And I'm just not sure, is it a dungeon or is it a zone? Because for this one, right, you have to take the quest outside of this zone, and there are four quests plus there are four quests outside plus one final quest to kill the final boss, which is a robot at the end. A robot at the end. I can't remember the name of the robot right now, but when I first did it in normal mode, it took me about 2 hours and a half to complete the own four of the quests and one final quest at the end. But I just can't remember, was it a dungeon or was it a zone? Because you take the quest outside and then you go in. Was it a, yeah, some, yeah, it's one of the elite content, but I just can't remember, was it a dungeon or was it a zone? But this one is required for you to do in order for you to get a quest for the green miniature. Green mini. This is one of the quests, and I already explained it in the devotion video, so have a look at that. Which is a few videos previously. Alright, so yeah, as for the dungeons, it the taste is vary. And the next one is recommendation. Well, obviously your armor has to be max armor rating. Your class, heavy class is warrior, medium is assassin, and ranger. Light is the casters. So casters. So anything to do with mesmers, ritualers, etc. That'll be in the light. Now your armor has to be equipped with the appropriate rune insignias that tailor to certain role. This is the key, right? I mean, like you can have the, you know, you can have the runes, you can have the insignia for particular dungeons and for a particular elite zone, but it has to tailor to the certain role. Because, for example, my Vosh Devish, right? I need to have a Windwalker insignia. Windwalker, was it an insignia? Was it a rune? I can't remember exactly. Windwalkers and the something to do with earth attribute. Oh yeah, I remember now. I remember now. Okay, sweet. Hang on a minute. Let me just clear this one up. Oh, what am I doing? So, you need to have Windwalker. Six of them. Yeah, six of them. And you need to have the Earth Rune. Superior Earth Rune. Super Earth. That plus 3 in your earth attribute. Attribute. And also that's plus 3 in your earth attribute. And then also you need to have a, because this one will plus 3 in your earth attribute, but it will minus you 70 plus 75% of your HP. And I think I put in the superior of Vigor. Vigor. And that plus 50 health points. And I think that I put in another one, which is the purple one. And the purple one, I can't remember the name now. Superior, minor, major, yeah, major. major one, which is plus about 30 something, 30, 40 something, I can't remember, about, yeah, I'm pretty bad with remembering the exact number for the rune. Yeah, 30 or 40 something, 30 to 40 something HP. And so to mag up with that, and I fill the rest with the energy. Yep, I fill the rest with the plus two energies. And so, you know, it'll give me a little bit more extra energy for me to use for my build, you know, to execute the skill spell. And so, yeah, you have to have the appropriate runes insignia for a certain role for that. And sometimes I have seen all the people that they have several armors. For the assassin, right, I have seen a friend of mine, he has three armors. Three armors, all of them, all of his armor, using different runes and insignia for different role. He runs Terra 1, he runs Terra 2, and he runs Main Tank as well. And but that's not only that, but he also runs these two the most. He runs this one, he runs this one the most. And because of that, he has three armors that tailor to certain role of these three. And I wouldn't be surprised if he has another armor for the Domain of Anguish. I'm not sure. So yeah, appropriate equipment for the certain content, yeah, I'll cover that. And also for the appropriate weapons. Now for the weapon, sometimes that they use spear and shield. And also they have a backup for the staff, for the energy management. For the staff, for the energy management, and they also have sometimes that they make up with the sword and shield as well. And so it's very, it depends on the role a lot, and I'll include a link down in the description so you can see what sort of you know, weapons and equipment that you will be looking for when you start playing a particular role. And then after that, you need to know how to use it. And Wikipedia, up in the Wikipedia, there is an article for you, along with a video for you to show you what how you can use it for certain roles. And I haven't done all of the roles, so I cannot show you each individual role. So that's why I'm referring you to the Wikipedia, so you can have a look at this particular role that fit with your playstyle. Because, you know, I prefer to be a damage dealer, but I want to learn about the tank as well. But I just don't have the opportunity to, you know, to be a tank yet. But I'll try to find a time, and I'll have to talk to my team members and organize a time for me to learn being a tank. But at the current stage, at the time of filming this, I haven't done any other roles aside from being a Vos Dervish in the official world. And for the underworld, I only been a damage dealer for my ritualist, and also for the semi sort of damage dealer and support, which is the signal spirit for the underworld. And that was pretty much it. And you have to know the content, and this is why I refer you to my three videos for this one, because I done it in the normal mode. And yes, I understand that I done them in the normal mode, with the exception for this one, because I done it in the casual speed clear. But by showing you how it can be done in the normal mode in every single zone, with the exception for this one, obviously. But I will also explain to you what zone am I missing in this map. And so by showing you that, you have an understanding of what the team would expect you to do. And I think it would be easier for you to learn about an elite zone by the old way. By the old way, I mean, you know, just go in and start cleaning them out one by one, one quest to another, instead of going inside the map, and then everybody divide their tasks, and they just boom, back off and do it. And when they do it, you just, you know, you just don't know what sort of what sort of stuff that the other guy is doing. And so you might be questioning, it's like, okay, hang on, what is he doing? Is there anything that I need to know, or is there anything that I need to activate for him when he was on the other side? And sometimes if you miss, you miss taking a quest or miss, you know, activating something, then it will be bad for the whole team. So it would be better for you to learn about the entire map from a perspective of doing it normally, throughout normally. But for the underworld, because I already said it many times in this video that I've done it so many times in the casual speed clear, so I just couldn't be fucked doing it again in the normal mode with my hero. So, but I'll try my best to explain to you using graphs and using pictures and using the video that I done the casual speed clear to show you what it's like. And I think that it will help you in understanding the dungeon. I mean, like the edit zone itself, the map itself. If you have any questions, feel free to leave your comment in the in my video, and I'll try to answer them as best as I could. And it's better for you to do it with your guild or the allies or someone who is patient enough for you, for them to teach you how to do it properly. And try to avoid to run with, you know, the elitists. Because sometimes, like, I mean, yes, they good, and they, you know, they have a very strict rule when they run it. But when you just start up, you don't know a lot about the dungeon, okay? You have a look at the videos, you have a look at the role, but have you actually been in the dungeon, or have you been in the zone itself and, you know, try out a combination by yourself? I'm pretty sure that when you have a look at the video, because I was the same, I have a look at the video, right, for several speed clear and speed run, and I also have a look at the zone itself and try to study it before I actually go in and do it. But when I go in and do it, I sort of like mess up not much, like a tiny bit. When I first start with the Voice Devils, I mess up with the combination. But after 4 or 5 attempts, you know, after 4 or 5 engage with the mobs, I sort of like get a hang of it. And so you need at least 1 or 2 or maybe even 3 tries before you can execute it perfectly. And I mean like perfectly to the point that you don't make any mistake at all. And you just like, you know, it burns inside your brain and you just like, you know, tap it 1, 2, 3 and go. So it will take you a few tries for you to execute your role perfectly. And you know, some people are very gifted, and for those people, you know, they're really talented, and because of that they can perform it one go. So I'm not sure what sort of person are you when you go in and do it. So just please be aware of that. And you know, I would advise you to avoid running with the elitists because of the strict rules and the pressure that they demand you to execute it perfectly. If you're not comfortable with that, do it with your guild or allies and tell them that you are new, and so they should be, you know, they should be aware of your ability, and so they will try to cover it up with something else. And again, lastly, practice. Practice, make it perfect. Alright, so that is pretty much what I want to say for the speed clear. The link down in the description will be available for you for all of the elite content that I have attempted, and also for the video that for a certain role for the speed clear, and also the explanation for all of the veterans that I have put into the wiki, so you can have a look at it for yourself. And if there are any questions, and if you would like me to answer them, feel free to leave the comment below and I will try to answer it as best as I can. Alright, so I'll see you in the next slide. In the next slide, I will include some of the extra one that you might be interested in. So for buy and sell stuff, trading, there will be no auction house in the game. Let me just be very clear for you, there is no auction house in the game. However, there are some NPCs that you can trade for, that you can buy off for the rune. Or rare materials, and you know, some of the dice and also some of the scrolls. And the NPC that I usually go for is located at the end park. That you know, that zone has NPC to trade for you the runes, rare materials, and dice and scrolls, and as well as giving you the Zaishan daily quest. Zaishan dailies. That's what I usually call it. Daily quests. All right. So there's no auction house. So now how do you trade? Well, you have to do it the old school way, that you have to wait in the outpost called Kamadan in the American district. American District 1. Yeah. And you stand there and then you advertise your products in the trade chat channel, and then you just wait for somebody to respond to you. And I mean, why doesn't they, you know, why doesn't the game allow you to, why doesn't the game invented the auction house? I don't know, you know, the developer, they didn't invent the auction house for you to save the time so that you can, you know, you can start doing the you can do the missions and dungeons, and then just leave the auction house to run while you doing other stuff. I don't know, I honestly have no idea. So, you know, when you start trading in the Kamadan region, you have to have your character wait there, advertise, and then wait for somebody to respond. Why your character is still waiting at the Kamadan is a waste of time, in my personal opinion, in some cases. Because, you know, I spend about 30 hours waiting in the Kamadan just for me to sell a couple of my stuff. And, you know, instead of waiting in that, I could do some other stuff. If I have the auction house, I can just, you know, advertise my stuff on the auction house, and then I go ahead and do something else. Save me a lot of time on, you know, wasting my time trying to trade in the Kamadan. And some of the items are not worth the effort in, you know, in waiting in the Kamadan trying to sell. So that's why I am giving you some of the method that that I used to try as well. But please keep that in mind, that Guild Wars Guru is the forum that I usually try. But some of the items that in there are not worth selling on the forum, because they are low tier end. And most of the people that have been playing Guild Wars 1 for many, many years, well, as you expected, their gears are at a high end level. And what you some of the items that you advertise to them might not, you know, appeal to them, because, you know, they have a better stuff. So Guild Wars Guru trading forum in under the sale category section, and also some of the one in the buy section, I usually try for high end gears and high, you know, rare skin, high end gear and stuff like that. So just please keep that in mind when you try to advertise on that one. Now there is a third party website called Guild Wars Auctions. This is exact writing of that website. I used it once and I didn't sell a lot of stuff in there. I mean, for the consumables, I did sell a number of them in this website, and I also did sell a tokens for the armor for the heroes, but aside from that, I haven't got any of my items sold in terms of equipment, like weapons, sword, staff, etc. I didn't get any of them sold in this website. So I'm just giving you the name of the website, so you go ahead and type it on Google and have a look at it, you know. But I didn't use a lot of this this website a lot, because I didn't get I didn't get my items sold in this website. So it's working, yes it is working, but in terms of item, I'm not sure, because I didn't get any of my items sold in this website. But I did buy a few from other players in this website. Most of the item I buy from this website is green items, and I didn't spend real money. No real money. No real money. No. I pay for them using platinums in game. in-game currency. Yeah, that's the money that I spend to them is the platinums. I would not spend any real money, and I don't think that they advertise in real money either. They either advertise it in platinums or they advertise it either in ectoplasms. And majority of the people of the seller in the guild auctions, they are gamers too. So when you use that website, you sort of contact the players in the game, add them as a friends, and then when you log online, you see them online, you contact them, and you know, you try, and then after that you go back to the website and start giving them the feedback. So was it a good website, was it a good try, or was it a bad try? You have to give them feedback on that. So it works as a like eBay auctions, but it's between players, you know. So there's no dodgy seller, but the amount of dodgy seller is quite low. They are there, but they are quite low, because you have to have a look at their feedbacks and see, oh, was it a good seller or was it a bad seller? If it's a good seller, they usually have a reputation. If it is bad seller, they usually have a low reputation. So you look into there and see, you know, what are the signals that you the red flag on the seller, like, you know, are they a scam or are they authentic, like genuinely a good trader. So there are signals for you to look at. Now for the build, for PVX, which I will include a link down in the description, where you can have a look at the builds that available in the game that people frequently use. I will also include a link down in the description that the build that I usually use for my for general purposes that I use the most, and so far it worked pretty well to me. And you know, but again, feel free to modify it to your needs, because obviously my preferences is different than yours. So if you you tailor it to your playstyle, feel free, because it's what you want, it's what you prefer. So yeah, there's tool for you to use, please go ahead and use it. And on veteran players, they have a Facebook. There should be players and half. Sorry about my grammars, because you know, at the final video, I'm kind of tired after talking for like what, nearly 2 hours already, 2-3 hours, I can't remember, it's been long. So for the own veteran players, they have a Facebook group called Guild Wars A New Hope. So if you want to have a look at them, please go ahead and do it. It's on Facebook, so just tap in on the Facebook search for Guild Wars A New Hope and it will pop up. And this is a community group that usually discuss about a game, and they usually socialize, and if you need help, you can ask people on that group too. And also if you have a guild, if you're looking for a guild, you can ask the people in that to invite you inside their guild too. If you prefer to use the Reddit, then there will be a subreddit at Guild Wars. It's not Guild Wars 1. It's just under the subreddit of Guild Wars only. If you need help or if you need a guild, just say on the subreddit. I usually visit the subreddit more on my Facebook. I don't usually use my Facebook that much, honestly. But if you are looking for a guild, you can submit your request at the subreddit at Guild Wars. Then a lot of people in my guild and also a lot of people in my alliance will respond to you. If you submit in there, and if I happen to see your name in the subreddit, I will invite you to the guild I'm currently with. So if you need help or if you need a guild, feel free to submit it on the subreddit or the Facebook, up to you. So yeah, this is just what I repeated myself. For guilds and allies, I highly recommend you to check out the either the Facebook or the subreddit, because a lot of own veteran players, they frequently visit the Facebook and also the subreddit. But I, me personally, I check on my subreddit more, because I usually look at the Guild Wars 2 community, and the Guild Wars 2 community is very strong in subreddit. And because of that, I frequently visit the Guild Wars 2 subreddit more, and then after that, I bounce back and have a look at a few stuff in the Guild Wars 1 subreddit. So the material is there, the group is there for you. If you need any help, feel free to use it. Feel free to use the tool to gain some help, and it's there for you. And I will also include a link in for the events cycle in Guild Wars 1 in the description. So as I mentioned earlier, that a lot of you will be interested in finding out what sort of events are available for you to get the rare miniatures, and also for get the consumable tokens, etc. I will include a link down in the description for you to have a look at the event cycle, so you can time it effectively for your timetable schedule from now on until the end of the year. And the same thing for the Nicholas the Traveler, because Nicholas the Traveler, if you when you start doing the when you start doing the campaign, and when you start doing the mob fan quiz, etc., then some of the mobs will drop the trophy tokens. And then for some of the trophies that you can exchange it for, exchange it to the Nicholas. And what he does is that he will give you a gift in return. And when you open that gift, sometimes you can get an exclusive items, weapons, equipment, or consumable that you can sell for a lot of money. So make use of that. And every single week there will be a different trophy tokens that you can exchange for the Nicholas. I don't have a name for this week, because I think this week is like I just can't remember on top of my head right now. So I'll include a link down in the description for you to have a look at, and so you can save some of the items for this week, or maybe next week or the week after, and then you just exchange it for the Nicholas the Traveler to get some of the exclusive items. And some of them are exclusive, some of them are very, very common. So just have a look at the market. If you have something that you think is can sell reasonably well, just have a look at the market. Oh, and I also forgot to include the Carmadon price check. Carmadon price check's website. Let me just I wouldn't say it's a price check, but it's more like a historical price list, to be exact, because some people they start selling at their own, they start selling and they want, so for example, me, when I'm selling one Ecto, I just shout on the at the Cameron outpost under the sale channel, and I say, okay, I'm selling one Ectoplasm for 10,000 gold, 10 platinums. And this website will record my sale, my selling price, and it will list every single one of the sellers that shouting at the sale channel. So when you have a look at the website, you can actually see how much are you looking for. But please be aware that some sellers, they might overprice, they might overestimating their price, and sometimes they're trying to sell more than what the current market expect the item to be. So please use this historical website as a caution, just caution with this website, because sometimes it can be when you try to advertise 50 ectoplasm for one item, and it turns out to be it's only worth about 20. If you can get it, so good for you, boom, you hit the jackpot. But some people when you advertise it for 50 ectoplasms, and it might take you you might not get it sold at all, and you have to do it, reevaluate evaluate your price again. And that's what the Keywords Guru forum is for, because you can ask for the price check in this forum. And it's free, it's there for you. For somebody, veteran player, when they look at your item and say, okay, I think it's worth about 10 ectoplasms, and other veteran players say, oh, I think it should be worth about 15. So when you gather the opinions from the veteran players, so you can estimate how much are you looking for to sell that particular item. This website is only for you to look at, to gain an opinion, but whatever you decide to sell, how much are you looking to sell it for, is entirely up to you. So yeah, I'll include a link down in the description for this website, the Camden Historical Price List, so yeah, you can have a look at it. So that pretty much it for what I want to cover for the extra one. If you have any comment on this video, feel free to leave the comment below. Is there any suggestions? Is there anything that I forget or any suggestion at all? Feel free to leave the comment down in the comment section, and I will have a look at it and I'll try to answer your question as best as I can. And again, thanks for watching. And just before I go, this is the overall info for all of the link that I discuss in my previous videos. If you want to click on any of these links, that's fine. It will lead you to the video that I have done, or the playlist for this one. For example, early content attempts in the game, it will display a playlist of all of the videos that I have attempted in my playthrough for the early contents. So yeah, the material is there for you, the videos are there for you to have a look at. If you have any questions, please keep that in mind, that all of my videos, right, all of my videos are just there for you to see it can be done, and it can be done reasonably. I did not try to do it as fast as I can, because at the time of filming that, I only done it just to get it out of the way. And I don't think I'll be, some of the missions and some of the, you know, the dungeons, I don't think that I will go back and start doing it again, because some of them are not worth, they not worth the time of redoing it. So please keep that in mind, that the missions, the dungeons and early contents, some of them are there just, you know, as a guidance. You, by all means, you can improve it and better at it, and, you know, it's good for you. And if you want to link me the video that you improve from my method of doing, feel free. I have nothing against it. I mean, you know, it's good for the community, it's good for you, it's good for, you know, the people, the guild members, the you know, the allies member that you've been playing with. And if you have friends that you want to help out, feel free to link the video you know, in the description, that okay, here, I mean, I have a look at your video, but I think that I can improve that, and here's my real video that I mean, for proof that this is my method is better than yours. Feel free. I mean, it's better for the people that you know, watching my channel. It's better for you as well, and for your friends and for your guild members, for your allies. Just by all means, link it for the video that you improve it from my method, or you have a better way of doing this, feel free to link it. I have nothing against it. It's better for the community in general. So by all means, go ahead and do it. And for the pet, and I will also include every single one of them in the link. And for the ammo token, again, all of the videos will be there for you. And go ahead, just click on any of the link if you want to have a look at it. And if you don't understand anything, if you unsure about particular topics or anything like that, let me know in the comment. I'll try to answer that for you. And again, I wish you luck. I hope this video and this playlist as a whole will have you form an understanding on this whole thing about the Horns of a Human, and also for the title of God Working Amongst Mortals. And I hope it can better assist you when you start doing it on your own. And I hope that when you do it, it will save you the time of, you know, instead of, you know, trying like me doing it everything, you know, the guidance that I gave you in my recommendations in my previous videos, that will help you in, you know, fastening the process of getting you 30 or 50 points or 50 or 50 points or getting the God working amongst modules. So again, I hope you enjoyed it. Go out there, have fun. If you successfully complete 30 or 50 points or successfully complete 50 or 50 points and getting your God working amongst modules, congratulations, you deserve it. It's not an easy thing to do, it's very time consuming. If you successfully completed, congratulations, good for you. Alright, so that's pretty much it. Again, have fun, good luck, I wish you all the best, and I will see you around. See ya.